people fighting me because I'm a blessed man. And people that get to me are blessed. Stay with me are blessed. I don't mean that privately. Listen to me. My spiritual sons are getting blessed beyond their wildest socks. It's amazing what's happening. The people in our church getting debt free. Then people come, they said, we were so broke. And 9 months later, I don't know how I'm out of debt. Well, sometimes you can't explain it. It's just God being God. Laban, he said, I learned by experience that the Lord God had blessed me for your sake. That's increased by association. That's not an accident. You that come to this church is not an accident. God wants you around. Yes. Richard and his wonderful wife, Kim. Why? Because they're going to increase it on. Hang on.
Yes. Come on.
Don't let time defeat you. You're not defeated by lack of faith. God, faith the size of a mustard seed to throw a mountain at the sea. The only place you can hide a mountain is in the ocean. You're not being defeated by lack of faith. You've got enough faith to handle anything. But you may be defeated because of the abundance of time. I don't have any more faith than you people do, but I might have a little more obedience. I'm going to throw the nets in there. You understand? I'm going to start walking. I don't know where I'm going, but I'm walking. And I ain't bringing a lot with me. Even though I might like it. And Abraham liked it. That's not the issue. It has nothing to do with life. It has to do with obedience. See, so you got to understand, increase has a voice that speaks very loud. Your association with it proves your devotion to God's word. That's what Laban is saying. He could see that voice was saying that increase is on that Jacob boy. And because he's working for me, we got to cheat, lie, steal to keep him here. So let's give him Leah, but just cover her. Because he's so excited. He ain't put the light on.
Isn't that amazing? Real powerful.
Just normal people like you. You got to be depressed. I want to give your husband away. Sarah, Abraham, you go in that tent. You have sex with my bond servant, Abraham. Abraham said, I'm going to do this for you, Sarah. You ain't going to say, you ain't going to say, what's up, Abraham? Then Sarah gets back. Because he has a son that he likes. Excuse me, Sarah. You told him to sow a seed. And then she gets treated bad. That causes the Arab-Israeli problem till today. You see, yet God blessed Ishmael. The only time the two boys ever came together was at his funeral. Ishmael and Isaac finally came together. They probably liked each other. But then you know how family problems.
Good word.
Blessing does not impoverish the Lord. Write that down. Blessing does not impoverish the Lord. You can ask God for so much stuff. Blessing does not impoverish the Lord. Increases his nature and duty. Go with me to Psalms 115. At this point, I didn't talk about it over there in Jacksonville. Psalms 115. I want you to see this. Let me show you what you have. You don't even realize it. Let me just show you. Psalms 115, right? My Lord Jesus. Verse 12. The Lord had been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron. Now he's talking about you, but you just see the Abraham. He will bless them that respect the Lord. That means fear. That means respect. Both small and great. It don't make no difference who you are, small and great. God Almighty, man. God just wants to be a blessing. The Lord, verse 14, the Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children. Why? Increase by association. Now, verse 15, you are blessed of the Lord which made heaven and earth. Now, verse 16, I love it. The heaven, even the heavens of the Lord, are the Lord's. That's it. Space is his. But the earth hath he given. Woo! To the children of men. Everything on this planet belongs to me. Why don't we get it? Because we don't believe for it. We don't expect it to happen. And it starts with a seed. That's how you get expecting. I had a friend of mine. I love him. He's a great guy. He had one of the prettiest wives you ever seen. Wonderful people. Been known him for many years. They came to my house. This is many years ago. Oh, 35 years ago. He said, hey, his wife's crying and he got tears. I said, what's the problem? He said, we want a baby. I said, okay. He said, but you don't understand. She can't have a baby. What do you call it? Gynecologist. The gynecologist says she's had endometriosis, which scarred her body, so she could never have children. They went to several gynecologists and stuff, and they said, can't happen. Can't. She was 21 then. This happened when she was 18, 17, 18. So I just looked at her. I said, the Lord didn't say that. He's trying to get me to believe what the doctor said. I'm not denying what the doctor said. I just deny it's right for them. I'm not fighting the doctor. That's his business. I'm not a medical doctor. I said, the Lord said, be fruitful. I just looked at him. I said, y'all want a baby? Oh, baby, we want a baby. This is in my house. I said, all right, everybody circle here. Me and Kathy, Carol and Cindy, grandparents. Jesus, they want a baby so bad. Yeah. They only want what you said they could have. So thank you, Lord, for giving them.
Amen.
I said, now go home and let nature take its course. Let's go. Well, 9 months to the day, they have a beautiful baby. 11 months later, they have another. 11 months later, they had a boy. Carol came to my house. I said, what's the problem? We got to stop this. How do we stop this? He won't buy the clothes away. I said, I'll tell you how to stop it. I said, quit sewing. He can't do that. I said, if you want to stop it, shut her down, boy. You see what I'm saying? Watch what you pray for, you may get it.
Yes.
Or you will get it. Blessing does not impoverish the Lord. Right now, I had a guy say, how much money would it take for you to do everything that God told you to do as of today? $6,364 million. That would say, I would say, Lord, done it, paid for it, it's all paid. Now either take me home or give me something else to do. That's 14 satellites, 7 low orbit, 7 high orbit. All, everything. Ain't nothing for God. One of those rocks that come at us, the asteroids, is worth in the trillions of dollars. They're not worried. They love to be able to capture them and bring them. They're full of gold, silver, uranium, iron, everything that we need.
Yep.
We're trying to figure out how not, so it don't hit us and destroy this planet. We can get it. One. Trillions. And you got the asteroid belt. Billions. That's just in our solar system. That's not counting the universe. It's beyond human reason. You see, God says, I'll do whatever you do. So when he told me to do this, I said, yes, sir, I'm yours to command.
Yes.
Just that simple. It don't make no difference. I even called NASA. I said, I want a satellite to last at least 20 years. What are we looking at? $500 million. I said, now if you fly that, put it in orbit, what's it going to take? Another $100 million. I said, thank you. Then I called Russia. I said, y'all taking up satellite? Yeah. I said, how much? He said, well, if you do it, we'll do it for $20 million. I thought, my God, man, one phone call. I said, $80
million.
But you see, the Lord took me out, woke me up at 3 o'clock in the morning. I said, come outside, I want to show you something. And I went outside. I didn't want to get up. I was tired. I said, what? He said, look up. Okay. I said, he said this. Richard, it went off like a shot. He said, no one owns space.
No one owns space.
Well, we get gets up here first.
Wow.
Think about that. No one can ever take the gospel off.
Mm. Yep.
Beat it to the world.
Thanks.
For free. And let the heathens pay for it. You ready for this? I'm gonna shock you with this. 4 years ago, I was invited to go to Wall Street. They wanted me to go to Smith & Lewinsky Steakhouse in Manhattan. They wanted to talk about my ideas. I have good ideas. I have ideas. God, give me ideas. I had $6 billion on the table. We want to invest. We're ready to go. After I did my presentation, we made $3 billion the first year. I don't care how much money they make, but they want to control it. No, the Lord said, get up and leave from the table. I said, Jesus. $6 billion. Get up and leave, they don't understand. They won't be able to do what I do. Anybody put satellites up there without money? What you gonna do with it? That was 4 years ago. They ever said, well, I walked away. I thought to myself, I can't. I said, I guess it's never gonna happen. You know, devil, I said, darling, that's not my thoughts. My thoughts are lovely, just for the report appeared about 6 weeks ago. A guy called me. He said, do you remember me? I was at that meeting. He said, we have never, ever stopped thinking about that. But we need you to do it. I said, I want to do it for one reason. I don't care how much money you make. Pay back the investors. They need to make money. That's not the issue. I said, what I want is no one can ever take the gospel off the airwaves, which means that I reach, I can put you on 24/7. It wouldn't make any difference. And the heathens will pay for it. Cell phone companies are going to leave. Just not. But they want to control. I said, no, it can only be controlled by one person. That's God Almighty. Well, how can you do that if you die? You set it up in the system, some good Lord is, that then whoever can sell it, but it's made for the gospel's sake. And no matter whoever gets in there, it can't change.
That's right.
There's ways of doing that. It will take some discipline, some dedication, and commitment, but that's all right. We can do that.
Yes.
I looked and I said, Lord, why don't you tell Bill Gates? He said, because he can't hear me.
Wow.
He's a good man. He likes to bless people. No. But you can hear me. Watch this. Faith me. That's what I say. Faith me. So blessing does not impoverish the Lord. Increases his nature and his duty. It's his nature to bless. It's his prerogative to bless. It's his glory to bless. It's his delight to bless. His blessing without season. Going back to the what I said to Kathy. I said that in your office. It was in Hawaii in February. And Kathy liked the shop. She learned it from Jerry and Carol Isabel. That's some shopping. I just go along for the ride. It's Jesus, Lord. But we were by ourselves. And make long story short, Kathy said, I'm going to that album one more. I said, get anything you want. She said, what? I said, buy anything you want. You can't break me. Give it your best shot. Whatever you see, get it. I don't care. You cannot break it. I got too much seed around. You cannot. It's impossible. You cannot break it. I'm not broke. I'm not even cracked. That sounds arrogant. Doesn't that sound good? No, that's confidence in the show. You know that woman shot for 12 hours? I had to meet her at a restaurant, and she ain't bought nothing. In a mall for 12 hours. I said, what did you do? Well, I wanted to look around, make sure I see everything before I buy. Then Jerry did it too. They called me up and said, meet me at Bubba Gump. I wore this watch today then. Jerry Savelle, Karen Savelle, and my wife, they all shot. Jesus, man. I'm the kind of guy walking and go, I like that. It's mine. Give it to me. I'm off the book. The only reason I didn't whitewash is LeBron James. I'm sitting in the hotel at the hip of Hawaiian Village, and I'm watching a little bit like that, and I said that. And they're interviewing LeBron James. All of a sudden, he goes, let me tell you what this. And I see this whitewash, and I said, well, that look good on you. I like that white watch. I'm gonna go buy another white watch. I don't know where you get white watch at that. So I went to Kalakaua Avenue, going toward Waikiki. And they said Chanel. I said, well, I like walking. I said, do you have men? Oh, yes, sir. I said, they pull us up. I said, I like that. I said, give it to me. Yes, sir. So all of a sudden, Kathy calls. Now, I never carry cell phones. I don't carry cell phones. But she said, she brought one. It's a flip phone. Looks like a Nike, baby. just in case something happened. She said, what you doing? I said, I saw LeBron James on television. Oh, good. I want to get you something for your birthday. My birthday was coming up. She said, buy it and pay for it. And happy birthday. They said, want to go to lunch? Yeah. I said, she said, tell them we're going to meet him at the Cheesecake Factory. I said, okay. Meet us at the Cheesecake Factory. We'll be there for about 12:30. This isn't happening. I said, all right. So, man, I bought this one. And they had this. Look, it's links.
See?
I said, I want that. That will make me a wedding band. You got a black one? Yeah, give me that one too. I got that. This stone was in a lady's necklace. This is agate. I said, that's in the plan.
Yep.
I said, I want that. The lady said, that's for me. I said, I don't care. I said, take the stone. Throw away the rest of it. Oh, sorry, that's a platinum. I don't care. I just want the stone. Well, we can't do it now. If you'll come back, I'll have to take it. I said, yeah. I said, I'm going to have a ring made. I want an agate ring. Mm. Simply because there was agate in the box. Mm-hmm. So when I got back, they had taken it out. Kathy says, what did you? She said, Jesse, you see that amethyst stone? Why don't you put that in there for me? I said, okay, put that stone in that thing. I don't know, necklace or whatever. So Kathy got that too. So I got to think of, and I like bracelets. I said, y'all got They said, no. So I went to my jewelry wall and I said, call. I said, you get most of your stuff out of Italy. Make this for me. This is what I want. See, it does this. They said, yes, sir. He said, it'll take about 6 weeks. I said, that's fine. So I could have that. I'm not showing off. But I started walking down the street. I mean, I had this on. People said, that looks good on you. I said, LeBron James. I saw LeBron. I'm trying to tell them they ain't going to be LeBron James. He said, it looks good with your hair. I didn't do it for that. I just did it because of LeBron James and a white watch. And I don't wear it much. You know? And I thought today, I said, I'm not going to wear a tie today. But then I found out that Richard listens to Jerry and Mark Barkley. They go to the bathroom with a suit on. No, it's not wrong with that. It's a blessing of God. I told that to Mark Barkley. I said, you know that dovetail's been out of season for 50 years. He always preaches before me. He's a great guy. Blessing of God. And I thought, Kathy said, do you like your birthday gift? Thank you. She said, well, you know, it's not my birthday. Let's go buy me something. I said, let's go. She said, I want to go too. I said, okay, let's go. I walk right in, the Japanese go, oh. I'm not bragging on that. Please, take it as I'm telling you all this because I'm going to receive an offer. Most people will never tell you this when they're about ready to receive an offer.
Right,
offer that going, go ahead. It could. God bless me when I leave blanket.
Exactly.
That's not the issue. But you see, I want you to understand, it has nothing to do with things. It's just things. And Hebrew says, 11 verse 1, now faith is the substance of
things.
Substance of what?
Things.
Scope of the evidence of
things.
Issue of
things.
Come on. Think about that for a minute. So before pray for you. We're going to receive an offering for this mission. Ushers, would you pass out these envelopes? Or are they really at it? This is a Jesse Planet's ministry offering envelope. Look at it. Look at it. Don't you think? Listen, they pass them out right now. I'd like you to take one. Look at me. I'm going to say something before you. Most people never say this. They say it'll kill an offering. I'm not broke. I never charge churches when I come. I receive an offering because of the anointing increases on me. It's on me.
Amen.
And all the times I've come for Richard, I don't know how many times I've been here. Have I ever charged you anything?
No, sir.
It costs a lot of money to fly that jet. Oh, let me help you. How many of you are my partners? Do you know when I fly that jet? The ministry don't pay for that? I'm not broke. I've been very good to you. I just like to be a blessing. I'm going to ask you to do this, and I want you to listen to me. If you don't do nothing yet, just take it off, and I'm going to just wait. I don't know why I need you to make an investment in God's work, and you know it's gone.
Yes.
I don't ever make an investment in anything because I know what's happening.
Amen.
And it's called good business.
Yes.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, my staff just thinks I can walk on water. They say, man, and they don't even think twice about it. I'm walking down the hall. Boss, we need some new fiber optics. You know, the ministry's growing. We had the best year ever in our ministry in 2017. We need the fiber. It's so much stuff. I said, oh, okay, how much is that going to cost? $150,000. Like it's not. Okay. Can we get it? Well, oh, wait, let me think. Thank you. See, because they can't spend that kind of money without my permission. They can only go up to $5,000 if it comes to my desk. What do you spend the money for? That's to protect my partners. I do good business. Watch that. They said, oh, you know those cameras you bought? Now, I'm TV department. You know the cameras you bought? 13 years ago, you and Joel Osteen, we had the best cameras money could buy. Joel, I didn't know Joel was just buying new cameras no more than about maybe 8 weeks ago. We bought the best cameras money could buy. ABC didn't have them, CBS, NBC, Fox didn't have them. Joel Osteen and Jesse Lawrence. And the NFL called me and asked if they could use my cameras to shoot the Super Bowl. That's a good deal. I told them, no, yeah, I don't want any football player busting up. Well, they're only supposed to last 5 to 6 years, 13. Because we're good at it. Just kidding. Well, and the reason how you get new cameras is that they quit making parts for them.
Mm-hmm.
It's called the American Company.
Yeah.
Well, to make a long story short, Sony and Ike and everybody showed up at home. They said, you know, Reverend, you may not know it, but Mr. Osteen just bought some. I said, oh, yeah. They said, man, can we look at your camera? He went, God, these things look in perfect condition. I said, they're God's. They keep them. They said, well, you know, now, I never thought they'd get better than HD. We had true HD. Because light cameras says HD, it's not what I call true, where you can shoot it up 200 miles or 26 miles up through the satellites and back, where it comes back exactly the way it was at first generation. You got it costs money. They said, we have some new ones now. I never thought they'd do anything better than HD. But now they call 4K and 5K and 8K. We'll be the first international ministry ever to have true 4K and 8K. Now, these cameras last 13 years have cost me $1.5 million. $1.6 million. Well, they said, awesome. Now these cost $2 million, $1.95 million. I said, well, I serve a Jewish God. I don't pay you. I said, now what else? Well, it's going to cost more. Yeah, they have switches and routers. And I said, no. Give me a bottom line. I'm a bottom line now. They said, we'll give you $100,000 for your cameras right now. We sold them overseas. It's not too bad, huh? I said, okay. I said, so we cut the deal. It's down to total everything. That's from switches, routers, all everything, 1.5. So we went for almost 2 million to 1.5. They said, whew, you cut a strong deal. I said, well, that's constant. They said, can we use your name? Use my name. Well, you know, when you bought these years ago, that went all over the TV world. And they're going to see how these things look like the day that they bought. If you look at the camera back there, you see that lens? The lens on these are about this long, and they're $100,000 to $150,000 piece, just the lens. The camera's a quarter of a million. The stand is $40,000. Need five of them. Think about that. So I said, okay. And I didn't want to do that. Ladies and gentlemen, this is why I'm taking time on. I did not want to buy no cameras. Because I got that airplane on my mind. The big guy for a 7X. Many of y'all know, if you get my magazine, you see it. But when those are not raising money on it, we're just saying, believe with us. Some people send money to it. And I don't have any problem raising money. But the Lord said, on that plane, this one will just come. It's Isaiah 65:24, before you ask, I'll answer. But everything else, He said, you can raise it, not that plane. I said, all right. He said, because I'm that plane's coming to a miracle. It's going to break something in the body of Christ, but they won't have to struggle. So I said, okay. And so I said, Lord, I think I can get another year or two out of him all day long. I think so. And the Lord said this, 1995. He said, what did I do for you in 1995? I went, Brother Copeland gave me a prophecy in August of 1995. He said, come, New Year's Eve, 1995, going to January 1, 1996, everything you've ever believed for will be in your hands. I said to myself, he didn't know that, but Lord, better get in a hurry, because I needed a jet, I needed a television, truck, and cameras, I needed land. Ladies and gentlemen, come New Year's Eve, and on January 1, 1996, everything I was believing for came to pass.
Praise God.
And the Lord spoke to me. He said, what makes you think I can't do it again, Jesse? He said, I'm kind of a businessman. I like to do a project at a time and then go on the next. And I said, forgive me, Lord. I forgot that. He said, I keep the books. So ladies and gentlemen, if you don't mind, I'm going to place your offering today toward those cameras. You already got quite a bit of money. Over $300,000 already come in. Well, just that quick. We're believing God for 1,500 people and give $1,000. That's 1.5 million. I ain't paying a dime. That's it. Yeah. How many of y'all believe 1,500 people will give $1,000? Oh, yeah. You ain't got to give it. Just hold the hand. I mean, you don't believe it. I just want you to believe it. I want to believe God for 2,500 people. We're going to get those cameras. It will be a blessing. And then, Lord, that will take us down the road in another 10, 15 years. That's what it's all about. I'm going to ask you to do your best. Don't give me anything that belongs to this church. Amen. God's not going to work Richard to help Jesse. Amen. Me and Richard are on the same team. Amen. See what I'm saying? But I'm going to ask you to do your best. If you're writing a check out, you make it out to Jesse the Gladys Ministry, abbreviated JDM. You get a tax deductible receipt when you give it. If you give in cash and you want a receipt, you got to give it your address. If you don't want to, they stick the cash in there. Sorry, we don't know who's fault. They're still going to the projects. If you give by debit counts, you know, bank cards, 30% of America does that. So the place to put that off, that credit card number, whatever you use, debit card. Look at me. If you give like that, you lick this envelope, seal it, so we can protect your identity. There will be a machine that opens this up tomorrow. It will extract what's up in here and will make this look like salt. So no one can steal your identity, any of your personal information. Now, there's something here called text to give. I don't know how to do that. And if you don't know how, ask your grandson, he'll help you. People say you can't give like that. Just read the envelope. I'm going to ask you to do your best. I mean, you believe $1.5 billion coming. I'm going to give God. This is May. Cinco de Mayo was yesterday. Believe God, May, June, it'll be finishing with that. Yeah. We'll order the cameras and go. They told me, just take the camera. We know you'll do this. Most people don't turn loose no 1.5 million. Actually, 2 million, their cost. I said, no, I said, we do everything in cash. I ask you to do your best, whatever that is. And I want you to believe for 30, 60, 100. I mean, can you believe that?
Amen.
It's on me. It should be on you. Oh, you offer me for the Lord. Let me pray. Jesus, thank you.